Hi, I'm Susan Taylor with Scripps Health in San Diego, California. Years of exposure to the sun can result in uneven skin tone, brown spots, and spider veins. But there's an easy way to enhance your skin's texture and appearance: laser treatments, which can also be used to treat acne. Joining us to talk about this is Dr. Edward Ross. He's a dermatologist with the Scripps Clinic Medical Group in San Diego. Dr. Ross is the director of the Scripps Clinic Laser and Cosmetic Dermatology Center. He specializes in laser surgery of the skin. Doctor, thanks so much for being with us.
Well, it's fun to be here talking about lasers.
All right, so how does laser treatment work?
Well, laser works by, you take a typical laser like this that I'm pointing to right here, by taking a handpiece, and we use a certain type of laser light, and we direct it to the skin. So we can direct it against anything you're trying to treat. It could be a broken blood vessel. It could be an unwanted brown blemish. It could be hair that you don't want. It could be a scar that you're better off with. So it's a good way to erase things that you don't want. And so what we generally do is we direct the laser toward a spot. And the great thing about the laser, it only targets the bad guy. So even though the laser spot may be fairly large, like this big square, it's only going to treat the bad guy. In this case, it's an acne laser. In another case, it could be a broken blood vessel. So that's the beauty of laser, is the precision of how it works. It's not just shooting randomly into the air. It's actually going to find the bad guy, treat that, and spare the good guy, which is the normal skin.
And this also helps with what, fine lines around the eyes and the lips and the turkey neck, as I like to call it.
Yeah, all that's fair game. So you have to have the right tool for the right job.
So in the past, lasers have been used primarily for cosmetic surgery to enhance the skin. But talk about laser surgery now to treat acne.
A lot of people have acne. 97% of kids will have acne at some point. And we have a lot of good drugs, but we have some lasers now for people who can't use those drugs. And the main laser we have that we're using now is a laser that targets the sebaceous gland. That's the gland that produces grease that fuels the fire of acne. So we're cutting off the fuel supply by using the laser. So we have these sebaceous glands are all over our face. They're constantly pumping oil. And what we want to do is just cut that fuel supply off. And that's what this laser does. We put it against the skin, and that laser targets the gland and shrinks it down by heating it.
And then when you use the laser surgery, how long are you zapping the skin with the laser?
So each little pulse that takes about the size of a postage stamp is about 7 seconds. So it's 7 seconds, then you move another 7 seconds. It's a kind of a long procedure to do a whole face, but it's because it's very sophisticated the way it cools and heats. It has to cool the good guy and heat up the bad guy. The bad guy in this case being that nasty sebaceous gland producing that grease on her skin that nobody really wants.
And so how is laser surgery different from regular surgery?
Well, laser surgery is precise. Non-laser light sources can do things, and surgical tools can do things, but the precision of laser is related to the specificity. In other words, it targets a specific red or brown spot. So if you're targeting a broken blood vessel, for example, the laser can target just the red and leave the normal colors behind, or just the brown. So the magic is the selectivity for a certain color. We use color contrast for the most part with lasers to tell the good guy from the bad guy, whether that's a scar, whether it's a red broken blood vessel, whether it's a brown spot, whether it's a wrinkle, whether it's excessive hair. That's the goal, is to really spare the good guy, heat up the bad guy.
And are there any side effects?
Well, typically there are some side effects, not necessarily complications, but side effects. So if you treat broken blood vessels, for example, many people will swell up for a day or two. You can do things, but the swelling may make it socially and kind of work-wise a little awkward. Some of the devices will cause some crusting, temporary crusting, like coffee grounds in your face. I had that done to myself a while back. And so you have to take that into account when you're going to do things in the next week.
And what's the downtime?
So the downtime is related to what we do, but for the most part, most people have a little swelling. They may have little coffee grounds for treating brown spots, and that normally is 3 to 5 days. That's the amount of time typically it would take to recover, to be able to kind of insert yourself back into your work or social activities fully.
And then once you have the laser treatment done, you need to avoid what and for how long?
Well, it's good to avoid a lot of chemicals that might interfere with the healing. So you would not, for example, put any kind of rejuvenation creams on your skin like a glycolic acid or retinoic acid. You want to try to avoid the sun as best you can and avoid dirty environments. Some of the procedures, when you have the crust, your skin might be a little more susceptible to infection if, say, somebody scratched your skin or you're working with horses, something where you were in contact with a lot of of germs, so to speak. So that's the main thing, is just trying to avoid contact with things that might damage the skin.
And some of the lasers, though, make you very, very sensitive to light, like you have to be in the dark for 24 or 48 hours?
There's only one device we use for precancers that does kind of compel you to stay inside for 2 days. But for the most part, most of our devices, as long as you're careful, you can go out and go off and do things relatively quickly within 3 to 5 days.
And then once the skin heals, what should you do or not do?
Well, once the skin heals, you want to continue to avoid the sun. That's just what we preach in dermatology. And also you want to use a good sunblock. And typically you want to resume whatever rejuvenation program you're on, or just a moisturization program. Normally we have people use tretinoin. That's just a compound that's been around for about 40 or 50 years. And that plus a sunblock is really the foundation of good skin care and good skin maintenance.
So how long do these laser treatments last?
Well, it depends a lot on what we're doing. If you are doing brown spots, for example, some of the brown spots will persist and some will come back, and that can be 6 months or a year. Broken blood vessels sometimes will stay away for months and years, but sometimes will come back soon. So it really relies on you as the patient to come back and tell me, well, some brown spots have come back, some red spots are still there. And then we retreat those typically within 3 to 6 months.
What are the benefits of laser treatments?
Well, I mean, the benefits of laser treatment are skin restoration and rejuvenation in general. That's really what we're doing. We're trying to take those things that you accumulate over time from the sun, mainly the sun. So sun, aging, and genetics are the three sort of parts of the aging triangle. And the only one you can really control is sun. And in San Diego, that's very challenging. So the real foundation of good skincare is avoiding the sun as best you can, and then you'll need less laser. So that's really the goal. So the less sun you have, the less likely these problems will pop up again after the laser. So a good investment is, once you get the laser procedure, you've invested that money and time, let's try to preserve that result by trying to do the best we can to be out of the sun.
Is there anybody who should avoid doing laser treatments?
Well, people who have compromised wound healing for one reason or another, maybe you've had radiation in an area for some type of cancer, that will make that skin in that local area a little bit more vulnerable, and we might avoid laser surgery there. Some people have systemic diseases that make their skin not quite as robust, and we might lower settings. But it's really going to vary a lot depending on the procedure and what condition that person has. For the most part, 99.9% of people can enjoy the benefits of skin laser surgery.
Any final thoughts, doctor?
Well, it's a great time to be a laser surgeon because we have lots of lasers and the range of applications continues to expand. And here at Scripps Clinic, we have so many different devices. We're bound to find one for you.
Doctor, thanks so much for being with us. We appreciate you taking the time.
Well, you're welcome. It's fun to be here.
If you want more information on laser treatments, just click on the link or go to scripps.org/videos. Want more critical information about your health? Please subscribe to our Scripps Health YouTube channel and follow us on social media at Scripps Health. At Scripps, we're here for good. I'm Susan Taylor. Thanks for joining us.